Western Sydney Airport has taken a big step towards operation, with the final touches being made to its runway. But with residents divided over the impact of noisy flight paths, the window for them to have their say is about to close.
The final layer of asphalt. This is the near-complete 3.7 kilometre runway. 55,000 tonnes all up, enough to cover 41 soccer fields.
All of these things are concrete steps towards Western Sydney getting its own airport, getting the jobs and getting the opportunity to travel.
While construction crews work on installing line markings and runway lights, a team of federal bureaucrats will be busy responding to public submissions, sifting through statements in support.
We need to get on with it now, prepare for takeoff.
And statements against.
We feel like we've been hoodwinked by the Albanese Labor government. We are now the most impacted community across Western Sydney.
Residents still unclear what the flight path impacts will be, but all concerns raised will be addressed as part of the project's final environmental impact statement.
It's very simple. We just want the flight paths to be fair.
At this rate, Western Sydney International is on track to open by the end of 2026. At capacity, 82 million people will pass through those terminals every year. That's a similar volume to London Heathrow or Dubai International.
If you ask people in Western Sydney what they're interested in, they want to know where can they fly and what jobs are available. So they're the two things I think we need to move on with.
Public submissions will be accepted until midnight tonight. Tom Hartley, 7 News.